Joining us live on the phone this morning is Jill Heneka, who is in Wilmington, North Carolina right now. Jill, thanks for being with us.
Hi.
Can you tell us what you see just outside your window?
Well, right now, the winds have picked up again. They had dropped since about 3 o'clock this morning when they peaked at about, we're going to say, 75 miles per hour. They dropped down earlier. Now they've picked back up to about 40 miles an hour.
Jill, we've been hearing about these evacuation orders being issued up and down the East Coast. Can you tell us what made you decide to hunker down and stay at home?
Well, primarily the evacuation order for our island was for, it was mandatory only for visitors and vacationers. Mm-hmm. If you had a property or residential sticker, you could stay on the island. They didn't make it mandatory for us to leave. However, there are two bridges leading to the island, and at about 40 miles an hour, those bridges do get closed. So we were advised that if we stayed, you stay at your own risk. My parents had owned this house for about 20 years and left for only one hurricane, and that hurricane turned inland and hit where they actually had gone for safety. So we decided we would probably be just as safe here.
Now, speaking of your home that you've had there in the family for decades, is there any damage to it right now? We're seeing how heavy those winds are.
The only damage we have are branches and a lot of leaves. Mm-hmm. We had boarded up. We have hurricane shutters on the sides and the front of the house, and we had boarded up pretty well, so we weren't too worried. Plus, the trees that grow on this island are called live oaks, and they're perfect, really, for weather events like this because they actually bend with the wind. Mm. So we're fairly fortunate.
You talked earlier about making it through a hurricane before. Being there on Oak Island and staying in your home this morning, what types of things did you do to get ready?
We had filled the bathtub with water. We had stocked up on water and dog food for our pets. As I said, we boarded up. We tied things down that couldn't be removed or brought in from the property, mm-hmm. Filled the freezer with ice cubes in the event that we lost power. We're fortunate because there are over 200,000 people right now without power. We have all of our utilities are buried, so we rarely lose power.
Wow, you got lucky there. Jill Heneka, thanks so much for being with us this morning. Stay safe. Our fingers are crossed for you this morning and also your neighborhood there. Thanks so much for talking to us and giving us a perspective from Oak Island, North Carolina this morning.
Thank you.
Now, you can keep track of Hurricane Irene as it hits. Just go to our website, KCRA.com. There you'll find all kinds of maps, including satellite and also radar images and marine temperatures in the Atlantic.